Now, of course, when any idea like that is explained, the first thing that we ask is it true? Is there a process of rebirth? Do our patterns go on and have influence to an illimitable future? But you know, as this idea is held by deeply thoughtful Hindus and Buddhists, it isn't a belief in something which we can't prove. It's really quite a self-evident notion. Think of it in this way. Supposing I make two statements. Statement one. After I die, I shall be reborn again as a baby. But I shall forget my former life. Statement two. After I die, a baby will be born. Now, I believe that those two statements are saying exactly the same thing. And we know that the second one is true. Babies are always being born. Conscious beings of all kinds are constantly coming into existence after others die. But why would I think that the two statements are really the same statement? Because after all, if you die and your memory comes to an end, and you forget who you were, being reborn again is exactly the equivalent of somebody else being born. Because we have no consciousness of our continuity unless we have memory. If the memory goes, then we might just as well be somebody else. But it seems to me that the fascinating thing about this is that although a particular set of memories vanishes, death is not the end of consciousness. In other words, we are deluded by a kind of fantasy. If we think of death as endless darkness, endless nothingness is not only inconceivable, but it's logically, absolutely meaningless. Because we aren't able to have any idea, much less sensation of nothing, unless it can be compared with a sensation of something. These two things go together. And therefore, I think what is meant is that the vacuum created by the disappearance of a being, by the disappearance of his memory system, is simply filled by another being. Who is I, just as you feel you are I? The funny thing though about being I, about feeling that one is sort of a center of the universe, is that you can only experience this I sensation in the singular. You can't experience being two or three I's all at the same time. Now then, it seems to me that this idea has three very important consequences. One is that the disappearance of our memory in death is not really something to be regretted. Of course, everybody wishes to hold forever to the memories and to the people and the situations that he particularly loves. But surely, if we think this through, is that what we actually want? Do we really want to have those we love, however greatly we love them, for always and always and always and always? Isn't it inconceivable that even in a very distant future, we wouldn't get tired of it? And this indeed is the secret. This is why the demon of impermanence is present. Because it is forgetting about things that renews their wonder. Just think. When you opened your eyes on the world for the first time as a child, how brilliant colors, what a jewel the sun was, what marvel the stars, how incredibly alive the trees. That's all because they were new to your eyes. read it years and years ago and you've forgotten all about the plot, it still excites you. But if you remember the plot, it doesn't excite you. So by the dispensation of forgetting, the world is constantly renewed. And we are able to see it again and again. And to love again and again, we have people to whom we are deeply attached and deeply bound. Always with renewed intensity and without the contrast of having seen before. Another concept is a very curious realization. Remember that question, who would I be if my mother had married me? If I were you, one might so easily have been you. I might so easily have been born in China. Why do I feel that the world is centered in this place, as distinct from some other place? You jolly well know the world is centered where you are. And this gives one a very strange feeling of the idea that other people jolly well exist in the same sense. Everybody's name is I. That's what you call it. So there will always be I. Every I is in a way the same I. We all might be anyone else. And there is no escape. It goes on and on, on, on. So long as there is consciousness anywhere, there is I. You then, in a way, look out through all eyes. And that, perhaps, is the secret of the great virtue of compassion.
Is explained. The first thing that we ask is it true?